Thanks for tuning in to TC 24/7's Halloween edition. I'm Dan Code.
And I'm Stephanie Schroeder. And this week, TC is all about the freaky fun things to do around Bloomington Normal, such as the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
But if you aren't into the scary aspect of Halloween, we also tossed in some family-friendly activities for you, like the Constitution Trail.
First up, let's check in with Maria, who headed to the Ghost Walk. And from what I heard, Maria's not a big fan of anything scary, so this should be good.
I can't wait, but what do you have for us, Maria?
Hey guys, it's Maria. We're on our way to the Haunted Hotel. I'm a little scared. Jamie's with me for moral support. So wish us luck, because I don't really know how this is gonna go.
Welcome to the Haunted Phoenix Mid-City Hotel.
You think that's creepy? It was only the beginning of our experience.
I can't do like ghost things.
Yes,
no,
the Maria.
The apparition. You're not. It's more of a smell, a touch.
If something touches me, I'm out.
Your camera. I mean, there's always that possibility, but it's just like you are the real ghost hunter.
I just don't really know if I can do this.
You have to,
Maria. You have
to.
We
have to.
I can't be on camera. We took a trip to the Haunted Phoenix Hotel in downtown Bloomington, and what we thought was going to be a typical haunted house surprised us all.
Doing is they're being the ghost hunters. I am a professional certified paranormal investigator. I've worked with people you've seen on TV, so what you're experiencing here is just like you would experience if you were on a real investigation.
Once they convinced us to go upstairs, we got our instructions on how to be real ghost hunters. Thrill seekers use these tools to see what they can find within the walls of the hotel. The Phoenix Hotel was later renamed the Mid-City Hotel, and everything inside is exactly how it was left when it was closed down.
It says original Mid-City Hotel doors.
The tour guides didn't want to ruin the experience for future ghost hunters, but we did get to walk around and explore the chills and thrills for ourselves.
Wait, so we're gonna have like a seance?
Yeah.
No.
Shh.
No. Be quiet.
No.
I tried really hard, but I'm a big chicken.
I'm the biggest skeptic ever, but that was so cool.
If you want to experience something a little paranormal this Halloween, you can check out Spirits of Bloomington on the web. Haunted tours will be given throughout Halloween, and reservations are required, so call ahead at 309-846-4306. For TC 24/7, I'm Maria Chandler. Now back to you guys in the studio.
Where you might check in, but will you check out?
Thanks, Maria. I thought you were going to have a heart attack out there. I think we need to switch to something that is little, maybe more like a 2 on the scarometer.
Well, I think I have something perfect for you. This week, Katie hit the campus to find out what people's favorite Halloween songs and dances are. And I personally hope the Thriller's on there.
Me too. Should I take notes?
I think that's a good idea. Katie?
Hey guys, Katie Schutzkus here, bringing you your music segment, and I'm on the ISU quad looking for some brave souls who are willing to show me some sweet dance moves for the Halloween parties I'm going to this weekend. So let's go check it out.
And so the search began for someone willing to strut their stuff on camera.
To my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the car.
Who can forget the Purple People Eater?
It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying Purple People Eater. One-eyed, one-horned, flying Purple People Eater.
Here's an old classic. How about the Addams Family?
They're creepy and they're spooky. They're mysterious and spooky. They're all together spooky. The Addams Family.
I discovered that the Halloween festivities even occur in the form of concerts.
Most Halloweens, actually, the last 3 years or so, I even have a jazz band gig this Halloween, but it's great fun. We even get to dress up sometimes.
Well, there you have it. Whether it's doing the Monster Mash or showing some sweet Purple People Eating skills, we have got you covered for the Halloween weekends. Again, I'm Katie Schutzkus. Back to you guys in the studio. Woo!
Coming up, we're checking in with Lauren and Brianna, who are filling us in on what's hot for Halloween this year.
Hey,
and here we go. Now walk it out. 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 Now west side walk it out. South side walk it out. East side walk it out. North side walk it out.
She was lucky. She wasn't born premature, but one out of every 8 children are. Some premature children go on to live completely healthy lives, but others face lengthy hospital stays, various illnesses, and even death. The March of Dimes is a volunteer health agency that promotes the health of children by funding research and education programs that try to prevent premature birth and infant mortality. For more information, visit the March of Dimes website.
Welcome back to TC 24/7. So Dan, I think it's about time we talk about our costumes. What do you have for us?
I'm a zombie. Brains! Rawr.
Oh, I get it. Well, I'm a cowgirl, in case you couldn't guess.
Very cute, very cute.
But it seems to be a popular trend on our show this week. And speaking of costumes, I think it's about time we check in with Lauren and Brianna, who got all decked out from head to toe and headed to a local Halloween store in Bloomington.
Let's see if they can top my costume.
Hey everybody, I'm Lauren Graham.
And I'm Brianna Mall here at Halloween Express in Normal.
And we're here to learn about costumes from the past and the present.
So let's go. Walking into the store, we found so many spooky decorations. Masks.
Lauren.
And costumes.
Halloween is the one day out of the year where you can be whatever or whoever you wish to be.
For example, the Love Guru or Elegant Devil. Some of the decorations even look real.
Ew. The meat shop.
Oh my gosh, the Tin Man, the lion, in my basket!
Lauren, it's you and me.
The store attracts people of all ages, from college kids.
These are cuter than the ones I have on.
To little kids with huge imaginations.
Last season, shopping.com noted a 30% jump in searches for sexy Halloween costumes.
It seems like the less material there is, the better it sells.
I found a really cool costume. I'm gonna be a hippie.
I found SpongeBob. We're keeping the tradition alive and hope you will too.
With so many possibilities, there's no reason not to.
So choose wisely. I'm Brianna Mall.
And I'm Lauren Graham.
Happy Halloween.
Thanks, Lauren and Brianna. But where's Toto?
I don't know. I guess Lauren just must have left him at home. But Dan, I have to say some of my favorite costumes are those based on everyday jobs, like policemen, firemen.
Sounds like you like men in uniform, don't you?
I guess you could say that. I mean, they're a little more my style than zombies.
Well, speaking of zombies, let's toss it over to Carter and Garrett, who are talking about a classic game, Zombies Ate My Neighbors.
More what? the hell are those things? Is that the crew?
Keep your voice down.
Get the hell out of there!
But now let's go over to Garrett for the Retro Minute.
All right, Carter. This week I looked back in my game collection at Zombies Ate My Neighbors, a rather bizarre monster adventure game created by LucasArts and Konami in 1993. In this game, you can choose to be one of two water gun-toting teens, Zeke or Julie, where two players can team up in a co-op mode to rescue their defenseless neighbors in 55 levels filled with hordes of enemies. The game is a mixture of retro horror flicks clashing just about every monster movie into one fun-filled fright fest. There are a wide range of enemies, including a giant baby. The levels vary from the backyards of the neighborhood to monster-infested castles. In each level, the player must find all of their friendly neighbors and rescue them before being able to move on to the next level. Players can make use of weapons and items like water guns, first aid kits, and various potions. The game can prove to be difficult at times due to the random chance of fighting weapons and items and being overwhelmed by monsters with limited weaponry at your disposal. And the password system lets you continue at every fourth level, but you aren't able to keep any of that hard-earned gear, so continuing the game at a later stage may seem pointless. Also, the game has no real storyline whatsoever, so don't go looking for one. However, these downfalls do not take away from the overall fun factor of the game. Even after 15 years, I still find myself drawn to this game due to the creative style and gameplay. The uniqueness sets this game apart from others of the same type. While it is a monster game, there is no gore save for some light cartoon violence. The game will provide a fun challenge for anyone and is definitely one of those classic games worth picking up again. That's all for this week. We'll see you at the next gaming update. Now back to Stephanie and Dan.
After the break, we get an inside look at a Halloween classic that has been a hit for the past 3 years.
Hey, what's up? You want to do something?
No.
Alright.
Are you constantly tired but still have trouble falling asleep? Have you lost interest in things you once enjoyed? Are you feeling worthless and empty? 1 in 7 college students will face depression. With the right treatment, 80% of those who seek help get better. If you or someone you know is suffering from depression, contact Student Counseling Services at Illinois State University.
Welcome back to TC 24/7. So Dan, have you ever seen ISU's production of the Rocky Horror Picture Show?
Of course, I've seen it the last 3 years here at ISU.
Really? Mm-hmm. Can you do the time warp?
I just know it's a step to the left, jump to the right, a couple other things, jumping and spinning.
Well, maybe we could work on that one after the show. But I actually had a chance to sit in on a rehearsal last week, and I'll admit I was doing a little singing and dancing myself in the audience.
Well, let's see what the theater department has in store for us this year.
This is ISU's fourth year in a row putting on the production of the Rocky Horror Picture Show. This is based on the 1975 musical film and will be put on by the Theater of TED this year. I stopped in for a rehearsal, so let's check it out.
Director Matt Sergott was contacted a few weeks ago and was asked to direct ISU's production of the Rocky Horror Picture Show. With auditions only 3 weeks ago, this cast is working nonstop to make sure their performance is a hit.
We rehearse 4 hours, 5 days a week, and for 3 weeks.
I had a chance to sit in on a rehearsal and watch this musical horror movie leave the big screen and come to life.
Right now, we're in the blocking phase, so we're staging everything, getting down mannerisms, a lot of quirky things that the characters do so they can get it into themselves.
And in case you don't know the storyline, Matt gave me the rundown.
Rocky Horror is the story of Brad and Janet. They are engaged to be married, and they get a flat tire and go to the Frankenstein place. And they get roped in by Frankenfurter. And they're both virgins, Brad and Janet, and they both end up sleeping with Frank, and he ends up manipulating them and getting his groupies around them. People start turning on Frank, people start turning on each other, and it all ends basically in an orgy.
So while this production may seem a little risque, it is a Halloween classic that the School of Theater could never turn down.
We limit the age, of course, because it's not appropriate, but I mean, it's been in theaters for 30 years, and people still go every midnight on Saturday to party, and there's kind of no way you can say no, because everyone gets offended.
Even some of the actors were caught off guard by the content.
Yeah, I didn't know what I was getting myself into, but now it's kind of fun. It's kind of cool. It's interesting. It's getting my inhibitions completely out of whack, so it's kind of cool.
And by getting your inhibitions out of the way, he means he isn't afraid to wear an outfit like this.
Fishnets, corsets, boas, maids' uniforms. We're just pulling, scrapping pieces together because thankfully we have the movie behind us, which provides the whole world, and we provide snippets and bits to help bring the actors into it and bring the audience into it. And the audience comes dressed too.
For the past 3 years, ISU has sold out every production of the Rocky Horror Picture Show. Right now, these seats around me may be empty, but director Matt expects a sellout crowd on opening night.
So until the audience arrives, the actors are practicing interacting with an imaginary crowd. They're also working on their singing, dance moves, and Matt even put directing on hold and got into his own character, Dr. Van Scott.
For the
But soon enough, he was back into his own character,
director. We still need to see your face. So if just one of them comes out, there you go.
After the singing and dancing, the cast moved on to the famous pool scene.
Toss, jump, there you go.
And while they don't have a real swimming pool, they don't have an actual set either. Instead, they will make use of the aisles and stairs. But I have a feeling the costumes and makeup will be more than enough. As the rehearsal came to an end, Matt left the cast with some encouraging words.
So even if you forget your words during the show, just sell it. Just sell it. You've got the words behind you.
And until the curtain opens for this production, the cast will continue to practice. For TC247, I'm Stephanie Schroeder.
So, when can I go see it?
Well, Dan, you actually have two chances, October 30th and November 1st.
Sounds fun, and Rocky Horror is such a classic movie. Do you have any classic favorite movies?
I think I'd have to go with the original Scream. What about you?
I think I'll go with the Dawn of the Dead remake, but let's see what Kendra Yago picked at the movies.
Thanks, guys. Halloween is probably the only holiday that has its own genre of movie, and I'm talking about a truly twisted horror movie. What better way to psych yourself up for this spooky time of year than by giving yourself a good scare with one of the many great Halloween flicks? Now, there are thousands of great ones to choose from, but here's a few of the classics. Think ghost stories are only for adults? I can think of one phrase that will prove you wrong. They're back! That's a line from the movie Poltergeist, where the little girl makes contact with evil spirits through the television set. Truly a classic scene that still sends shivers down my spine. The movie follows a family from suburban California trying to find the American dream, but instead find ghost activity through the static of their television, which leads to the kidnapping of their little girl, Carol Ann. Will the family be able to fight the ghost and the demon beast to get their daughter back? Find out, and maybe lay off the TV for a couple of days, just in case any static flares up. Ghost just not real enough for you? How about a child murderer? And no one fits that role better than Freddy Krueger in the 1984 classic, The Nightmare on Elm Street. It all starts with one girl's haunting nightmares of being stalked in a boiler room by a man with razor knives for fingers, and then is murdered in her sleep. As such disturbing dreams become more common with the area teenagers, they set out to find out what or who is causing the dreams. But what they discover is only vagueness between the real world and the prisons of one's mind. I recommend watching this movie with all the lights on and wait a good couple of hours before you try to get some sleep. But if you're like me and aren't much for scary movies, I can personally recommend my favorite Halloween movie. It's The Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown. While this one doesn't hold a candle to A Charlie Brown Christmas, I find it a fantastic choice to get you in the spirit without flinching in fear. The movie is based on little Linus as he waits out in the pumpkin patch to witness the appearance of the Great Pumpkin. Meanwhile, his trusty friend Charlie Brown goes trick-or-treating and somehow ends up with a bag full of rocks, and Snoopy takes off in the Sopwitch camo to fight the Red Baron. This movie is nothing short of adorable, and if anything, it'll teach you not to cut out too many holes in your ghost costume. Now, like I said earlier, there are tons of great Halloween movies out there, so if none of these tickle your fancy, I recommend checking out www.halloweenmovies.com for a more extended list. And if none of these strike fear into your heart, just do what my mother always suggested to me. Go look in a mirror. And that's all for your movies this week. Now back to you guys.
Stay with us as we head to a famous trail that is taking on a new look for Halloween.
TV10 has made an upgrade. An innovative set. Fresh graphics. Original music. And a new mission to serve your campus, your community, your life.
So Stephanie, what if I can't handle the really scary haunted houses?
Well, you could hide behind me, or if you're a little claustrophobic, Chip Brewster has an alternative for us, so let's hit the trail.
As you're walking down the haunted trail, you're constantly searching the woods for the next thing to pop out at you.
Gotcha.
Haunted Trail in Normal draws nearly 1,500 people a night during its short season. If you plan on going, get there early to avoid the long lines and make it to the entrance before they reach their 1,600 patron limit.
Before we can go through, there are three things you need to know. Number one, because this is a non-scary weekend, if you do not touch the monsters, they will not touch you. The second thing is if you get scared for any reason, you can yell, "Monsters, monsters, go away," and the monsters will leave you alone. Say it with me. 1, 2, 3.
Monsters, monsters, go away!
The trail was decorated and populated with creepy crawlies and friendly faces. I even got to dance with Frankenstein. This past weekend, you could find witches, scarecrows, princesses, mad scientists, and plenty of ooey gooey things to touch. Even with all of this fun, one of my favorite parts of the trail involved a simple strobe light. But oh, how it entertained.
Like the craziness that you can do with your hands, I don't know if that'll come through. Really? It's like...
By the time you reach the end of the trail, you may not want to hoof it all the way back. Well, no worries. The trail provides a tractor-pulled hayride to bring you back to the entrance. For some attendants, this was their favorite part.
You like the hayride?
Yeah!
All right. So this first weekend right now, it's not the scary weekend. This is the kid-friendly weekend. Of course, this is the one I'm at. So by the time you guys get to go, all these people won't be standing here like ready to wave. They'll be hiding in the dark, trying to jump out and scare you.
Really scary?
Being that you've already missed the kid-friendly weekend, I wanted to attempt a preview of what you might experience this weekend on the Haunted Trail.
This is like...
Oh man.
This is no joke. This is no joke. This is a scary trail. Oh.
Okay, this next bit scared me. Watch how this kid runs away, but suddenly reappears without any warning. Creepy.
That was the best interview of my life. I'm submitting that one for an award. Yeah.
Oh, you're back. Hey.
Welcome back. Grant! Grant, there's been a mistake. I don't know why I'm here. This isn't right. This isn't right. Let me out.
So be forewarned, this weekend is not for the faint of heart. Be brave, or at least bring a brave person with you that you can hide behind.
So at the very end of the trail, they have a little cup of hot chocolate waiting for you. And whether you got scared during it or just plain cold, it's a perfect way to end your jaunt down the haunted trail. For TC247, I'm Chip Brewster. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Chip. It seems like you had a lot of fun out there with those kids. But personally, I'm excited for the more adult version this weekend.
So what else is there to do this weekend for Halloween?
Well, I'm sure there's plenty of haunted houses, but let's check in with the weekend warriors, Stacy and Meredith, who have the whole scoop on what's going on this weekend.
Welcome to Weekend Warriors. I'm Meredith Van Campen.
And I'm Stacy Compton. And we've got just what you're looking for to cure your Halloween boos.
ISU's Department of Theater may put audiences on edge with their play Dracula. Dracula has been scaring audience for 80 years. However, the weekend of October 24th and 25th and October 28th through November 1st, he will be haunting the ISU Center for Performing Arts. But don't be frightened away. Some humor was added to lighten the stakes. Unlike the vampires, the curtains rise at 7:30.
Rise from the dead with some ghoul times in downtown Bloomington's bar scene over Halloween weekend. Get your best Halloween costume on because the various downtown bars will be hosting a variety of costume contests and theme parties. Those of age are eligible to enter in costume contests and have a chance to win several different prizes. These prizes range from hats, cash, and even a flat screen TV. There is even a chance to win a trip for two to the Caribbean at one of the bar's Jimmy Buffett themed nights. Not only will there be fun prizes and music, but some bars will be having karaoke too. I just might have to start revamping my costume because that flat screen TV sounds pretty spooktacular to me.
One way to not get spooked while trick-or-treating this Halloween weekend is to go out at the appropriate trick-or-treating times. They are Friday, October 31st from 5 to 8, so don't be late. I know this cowgirl starting exactly at 5, so I can make sure to get a ton of candy.
Totally rad, dude. I'm getting my hippie gang together for some groovy times downtown Bloomington Halloween weekend. And that's our Halloween weekend events.
We're your weekend warriors hoping to carve you out some good times for the Halloween weekend.
Thanks, Stacy and Meredith. It seems like there's really something for everyone this Halloween.
Definitely. Well, that does it for this week's episode of TC247. Don't forget to email us with your comments and story ideas at tc247@ymail.com.
As always, thanks for tuning in to Bloomington Normal's only entertainment show, and have a safe and happy Halloween.
So I took a look at a dresser. Is that my dresser or something? I stepped in for a person.
Brains.
But it's just like you are the real best.
I just don't really know if I can do this.
You have to.
Maria, you have
to.
You have to.
Brains.
I forgot to say
Brains.